WKDA FM in Nashville, Tennessee. And now we go to the accident at 2208 Elliston Place, and here is FM 103's Harvey McGee.
Good morning. Welcome to the Exit Inn on Elliston Place with one N. We're here tonight, compliments of the Sound Gallery, who is sponsoring the show, with two locations in Nashville. One in Green Hills at 4012 Hillsborough Road, and Service Merchandise Plaza Rivergate on 2 Mile Parkway. They specialize, if you haven't gathered from the name, in sound systems, and Pioneer, tuners and amps, Advent speakers, and dual turntables. And in fact, those three items make up a system that they'd like for you to hear. Anytime during the day at those two locations, the Sound Gallery, we're pleased to have them as a sponsor. In the last few months, if you haven't been reading any literature, or if you have, on Nashville and Nashville music, you'll probably know that a lot of things are happening here as far as people appreciating what's been here for a long, long time. And tonight we're honored to have a couple of people that have been around here for a while and are about to get the recognition they deserve. Norman Blake and Tut Taylor. Welcome them, please.
Left me this morning. Now as that old clock was striking four, and that smiling face of my darling I may never see again no more. And I know what it means to be lonesome. Yes, I know what it means to be blue. Lord, I know what it means to be lonesome and dream somebody's missing you. Take one, boy. Darling, and no one knows all the pain that I've gone through. Will I just give all I own, love, to get you back home? I'm lonesome, lonesome for you. And I know what it means to be lonesome. Yes, I know what it means to be blue. Oh, well, I know what it means to be lonesome in dreams. Somebody's missing you. Here's picking again. Yes, I know what it means to be blue. Well, I know what it means to be lonesome in dreams. Somebody's missing you. Yeah, okay. Thank you. Well, it's good to be back on the radio again, ain't it, Tut?
Heck yeah.
All right. I think this is Genuine Radio.
This is
sure.
One of the kind of radio stations when you turn it on in the car and the light turns right, bright orange, that's when you're on the station?
When you get right on the station. On my radio, I think it's green or blue or something. I
got mine's orange.
Different kind of radio than you got there. turn your radio on. That last tune was an old 1935-ish Arthur Smith, Sam and Kurt McGee type song called Know What It Means to Be Lonesome or Lonesome for You.
Did Johnny Collins play on that?
He did on one cut we did, yeah. Let's do something else. Oh, we'll play something on the dobro on the guitar. What about a little pick and flat, maybe, that song?
Let's stick with this other one. It's got
you'll
two
do
chords,
that?
The key of D.
Okay, I know what that
it's
is.
It's called Running Wild.
Okay, that's good.
Are you going to take a break?
Yeah. You want me to start you off?
Oh, yeah.
Do an old song called Wayside Tavern. We'll do that. We'll do that in the key of E. Into a wayside tavern, the smell of drink was in the air. Laid my money up on the counter. Pretty young maid was standing there. Said when working hours are over, I would just love to see you home. Said, young man, it'd be my pleasure. Soon we found ourselves alone. other. I felt that knife stick in her back. Turned and saw her lover running. Said his name was Barroom Jack. Thoughts of this one so fair that I met that night in a wayside tavern where the smell of drink was in the air. I get Tut to do one here that is one of my favorite tunes that he wrote called Pickin' Flat. He says he's having a little trouble seeing up here. This psychedelic yellow bug light here is kind of getting to him.
Yeah, I need one of the shell, no pest strips to hang right up here.
Thank you.
to tell David to turn off the radio and go to bed. It's a little bit late for him to be up listening to the radio. Either that or pull the cover up over his head where he can't see what's going on.
We'll do that one.
We got to do the first train first.
I think we have a little bit of slightly different audience maybe than we did the first set, so we'll maybe repeat a couple of numbers there that you asked for. We'll do this one called Uncle right now.
Do you know if his radio station goes to Goodlettsville?
I sure hope it goes to Goodlettsville.
We got some friends out in Goodlettsville, so we thought we'd play something for them. They sleep, but somebody can tell them about it tomorrow. What you gonna play?
You dedicating the whole show to them, in other words.
Yeah. And what I really meant to say to Bill Monroe to get up out of bed. What you gonna do?
Gonna do one called Uncle. Left him here behind. Came one day to live with us when I was a child. Still he had to ramble around the countryside a while. Money was scarce and times was bad. The groceries mighty plain. Was it to do over was to live them times again? He always rode a horse or mule he traded for somehow. It learns a boy just to have someone to show him things sometimes. Set him straight on down the road, Lord help to ease his mind. Money was scarce and times was bad. The groceries mighty plain. Was it to do
someplace.
nothing's left to show but an old brown fiddle on the wall hanging next to a worn-out bow. Money was scarce and times was bad, the groceries was mighty plain. Was it to do over, boys, I'd live them times again. Money was scarce and the times was bad, the groceries mighty plain. Well, was it to do over, boys, to live them days again? A little song called not the Church Street Blues, but the Richland Avenue Rag. I'm kind of getting things crossed up. I told the people here at the first set I've been riding a bus about 26 hours from up in Minnesota where there's a lot of snow on the ground, and I thought that I never was going to get out of there. It seemed like we just kind of outrun the snow and got down to Chicago, and by the time we got there, it started there.
Did the bus ride drive 50 miles an hour or 55?
I don't know how fast he was going.
I drove into the exit in tonight, you know, at 50 on the interstate.
Yeah.
And I stopped the car twice to get out and see if it was moving.
Another profundity there.
A what?
Profundity.
I know what I meant something about not going to school.
This is the Richland Avenue Front Porch Woodpile Rags. Name of this.
Seconds to do a commercial. If you want to learn to play the guitar like that, get you 12 copies of Mel Bay's Guitar Method.
All right. I don't know if I can remember the words to that. I swear I haven't sung that song in an awful long time.
He normally does that in the springtime.
I'll have to think about that one, really. I'm serious. I don't know if I remember the words. Let me play you a little medley. Okay. Let me play you a little medley here and of some tunes. First one is called The Minstrel Boy, and the second one's Ash Grove, and then the third one will be The Cuckoo's Nest.
request do you have? What request do you have? Somebody said sing.
Somebody said when the fields were white daisies.
Let's see. I won't guarantee this. Once a maid said to a soldier who was surely traveling over to a land across the raging ocean foam, where the bullets fast were flying and in numbers men lay dying far from the peaceful shores of home. Meet me yonder, won't you then, love, down the lane by the pine grove. When you come home from a far and distant land to the hillsides green with clover, after all the fields of war's over, when the fields are white with daisies once again. Church Street Blues. That sounds like Charlie Hardeman out there.
Yeah.
Charlie, I didn't know you were still here.
Don't say that too loud. He might not supposed to be here.
A voice from in the darkness. We really can't see a thing up here. We kind of are playing to a black
void
out there. We just kind of look off and there's nothing out there. We see a glow from a cigarette or something.
That
strikes. So there's a man striking a match right there. Now we can see.
Now we know how it feels to be in the middle of the energy crisis.